So we're currently under lockdown in Sydney. Funny enough, in this video, I was actually just gonna go through an introduction of saying what we're gonna do in the photo shoot, but I've actually done the photo shoot and didn't do the intro, so this is the intro. So in this photo shoot later on, you're gonna be able to see my friend Maddie from Ben Descender actually sent us a deck of cards. Actually, wait, let me get the cards. Maddie sent me one of this from Ben Descender. It's an adult drinking game. Essentially, I looked at it. Some of the questions in there were pretty ridiculous. Yeah, so that's what I ended up shooting. He really did as well in terms of, you know, making me real busy, just trying to come up with an idea to shoot this. The idea that I had in mind was four of me, four of your boy, John Tan, drinking and playing this game. This idea was inspired by Gakuyen, a guy that I've been following for quite some time now. And if you've seen or follow me on Instagram, you've seen like the couple of reels that I've done. They're not quite videos, not quite photos. They're like 3D GIFs kind of thing, especially with this one where it's his friends, just real simple scenario where they're just all drinking, clanking the little glasses thing. They set up with the first shot of them in the scene. Second one is just them cheering. The third one is just them drinking. So I was gonna do a similar sequence to this, but this is gonna be a pretty complicated one considering there's gonna be two of me in the same shots. So yeah. The main concept you gotta understand is it is pretty much three photos stitched together in Photoshop, then Premiere Pro, and then you just merge the photos, right? By each photo that you would take, you're pretty much moving from left to right. So you take a photo on left, middle, and then right, and then you merge it together and have your subject in the center. Now, the problem here is that because we're gonna have two of me in the same shot, it's gonna be really hard to try have me perfectly in line and everything. So I guess you would have to do it with a tripod, but you have to do it in the exact same position. So that means we just gotta mark out specifically how this is gonna go. Here's the problem. Not only do we need to make me look like, you know, I'm playing the game with myself and look like I have no friends, but the thing is, I have to stay in the same position for both of my characters, and also to make sure each shot taken for those three images, left or right, are in the exact same spot when we take photos of the first character and then the photo of the second character. Sounds really complicated, but I hope by the end of this video, it does make sense. Also, just quick side note, we'll be shooting this at night, so it doesn't look like we're drinking in the middle of the day. And more importantly, we don't have weird lighting situations where one photo is gonna look a lot brighter than the other and one's gonna look darker, vice versa. All right, now that I've explained everything that is gonna be challenging about this shoot, let's get right into it, start setting it up. I don't even know what I'm wearing right now. I will be getting changed for these different shots as I play different characters of each John playing this game. But for now, table's looking pretty good. We'll probably jump straight to doing our first shot. Let's go. All right, that was a massive trek trying to freaking organize the perfect shot, I guess, frame it right. So now, because we've got everything in place, we're gonna be masking the exact position where my tripod is at the moment. So as we said before, you know how you gotta take three shots. This will be the first one, and then we're gonna move it over a little bit, get that one right, and then do it again and again and again and keep masking it. So we'll see how it goes. Now that I'm pretty much all dressed up for my first shot where I'm gonna be sitting there, right, we've got all these markings here. Obviously, I won't be able to take the shots. So I'm gonna have someone helping me to move each box, right? So after taking one shot of me over there, they're gonna move one box over, take a shot, move one box over, and then take another shot. Hey, now we're in the editing room. What's up? I'm super pumped to edit these photos to show you guys the process behind, you know, putting this whole sequence together, because boy, is it satisfying. And yeah, I can't wait to show you. Well, also, if you're wondering what is in the corner over there, that is pretty much my wardrobe currently under construction. There's going to be a whole video on it later on where I'm going to, you know, talk about a wardrobe transformation or makeover. Not quite wardrobe, more like a bedroom makeover, right? So there's that. All right, so I've just opened up Lightroom and organized all the photos that I took, selecting my favorite photos from the bunch, rating the photos so that I have the same frames put together, and edited them to my usual moody look. After that, I selected the ones that I liked the best and brought it over to Photoshop. Guys, this is where organizational skills will come in handy, because once you're on Photoshop, it makes it so much easier to select the photos from Lightroom that are the same frames. It'll make more sense later. All right, because what we're gonna do here is put two Johns together on the same couch, right? So now once you've layered two photos together that match on top of each other, it is now time to mask in another John Tan. Wait for it. This is probably the most exciting part. Yeah, baby, it's coming along so well. Look at that.
You! Oh, so satisfying. All right, so after you've done merging your shots together, bringing in the party to life with me, myself, and I, it is now time to make each photo a GIF. As you can see here, I've created 5 different folders simply titled shots 1 to 5. Each folder will contain the 3 shots as we've just previously merged. By this stage, we've edited the colors, bring the Johns in together, and also made ourselves a mini sequence. All right, now this part here can be a little bit tedious and I guess annoying, but what you wanna do here is line each photo up within each folder, centering everything so that it stays consistent. So yeah, I guess repeat this process for each folder. Now, to make a GIF, we've got to enable a timeline in Photoshop. And you can do that by searching for it in the help bar. I didn't even know there was a timeline in freaking Photoshop. Anyways, when that comes up, click on this 3 mini rectangles in the corner to view your timeline in frames. And under each of these frames, you should have it for 5 seconds. Now, link each photo to the frames below by toggling the eye icon, only enabling 1 photo per frame. Frame at a time, working from the bottom up, just like when you're playing Bender Sender.
Okay.
Now, once that's done for each photo, it's time to export this into a GIF. To do that, go File, Export, Save for Web Legacy, and make sure your settings is all under GIF, Adaptive, Diffusion, and whatever the hell that is on my screen. Because to be honest, I don't even know how the shit is on my screen. Like, I have no clue. All I know is either turn it into a GIF or a JPEG. And also, you can't miss out on this one last part. Like and subscribe so that your Photoshop doesn't crash. It's an imperative part of the process. Oh boy. Oh yeah, no, but seriously, one thing I forgot to mention is that make sure you're exporting each of these shots as its own GIF, because when you're putting them together, it's just gonna make the cut so much more seamless and clean, just like the cut I'm gonna have after this freaking lockdown.
Okay.
Oh, my hair's grown, look at this. That's why I'm wearing a hat in the middle of the night. But yeah, anyways, you still with me? It's a lot to take in, I know. But hang in there, son. We're getting there. We're getting there. We're so close. We're almost done. We're not almost done. We're close, all right? Hang in there. All right, now open up Premiere Pro, bring all your footage in, and chuck them on the timeline. Now buckle up, ladies and gentlemen, because this is the next step that's gonna be the most important, as your 3D GIFs will come to life. So hang in there. You see that because each of those GIFs are 15 seconds long, what you wanna do here is right-click each clip, go to spin duration, and change the time to 1 second. After that, make sure you change the time interpolation to optical flow. Hit enter to render that clip. Make that render bar green. Now that you've done your froze clip, do that for the rest of the shots and organize your sequence. Hooray. Hold up, John. If there are 5 shots and each of these shots is 1 second long, why is your sequence less than 5 seconds? Well, good question. That's because I went ahead and trimmed all the sections that I didn't even need, as they were static and served no purpose at all, as they were just frozen frames. So yeah, go ahead, chop them up. They kind of make it look like you're freaking lagging. But yeah, so far it's looking pretty clean. It's looking pretty clean, guys. We're doing good. We're doing good. You're doing good. Okay, I don't normally bring in music at this point, but I'm just excited to see how it's gonna look. And yeah, look, after I've selected my song, which is from Project X. To the break of dawn, yo! But yeah, obviously not to that extreme. All right, now to make your sequence rewind and repeat for the gram, we'll be making it a nested sequence. To do this, highlight your clip, right click, head down to the nested sequence and name your sequence. Now duplicate that nested sequence, right click, speed duration, then tick reverse speed.
Would it reverse here?
Alright, copy and paste this for a couple of times to get your sequence to around 15 seconds or so. So now when we've played back, we've got ourselves a pretty solid reel for the gram. Now export that motherfucker and we got ourselves a reel of me playing with me, myself, and I. Man, for all of you that have stayed to this part of the video, you... Ladies and gentlemen, you guys are the real MVP. I'm putting you up on the podium. Thank you very much. I appreciate it for you watching my video. I hope you actually learned something. And also, once again, thank you to Bender Sender. If you want to check out the link in the description below, I will link that to their website so you can get one of these yourself. Or if you just want to check out what they're up to, hit them up on Instagram at BenderSender_. And of course, if you want to follow my journey, make sure you check out at john10.creative to check out more of my work. Any questions, comment down in the description below. And let me know if you actually try this. Also, check me out on Twitter because I've just hopped on there. I've no idea what's going on. Yeah, feel free to find me on Twitter at john10creative. I think it'll be really exciting to start using that platform to, I guess, share my stuff. Also probably just my videos, to be honest. I don't know if I can post that much photos on there, but yeah, I'm a bit lost on Twitter. But yeah, I'm happy to get some new friends on Twitter, so if you want to hit me up, follow me there. And I guess ask some questions. I don't know if you can do that. Tweet at me. Anyways, that's it for today. I hope you actually learned something. Peace. See you later. You have a beautiful day. What else do you want me to say? Have a beautiful day. How many ways can I say goodbye, huh? Peace. See you later. Have a beautiful day. God bless you. Have a great weekend. I don't know if it's the weekend. I don't even know when I'm putting this out. But yeah, pumped. Peace.